Kerry State and would really benefit the most from the interventions you've been talking about. And most likely, suffering from disorders like PTSD. So that's something I would welcome some kind of further exploration of. And I think it's a challenge, isn't it? But I think they are the people most in need, women or men.
Thank you very much. Thank you for coming. Would you like to say something? Yeah, why not? Last word from
you. This is clearly a very difficult problem, the fact that that women are in prison. And it has to be addressed. The prison system here is geared, I think, to a large extent to women who have mental problems, who probably should not be in prison at all. But then, as far as I understand it, there are very little provision for people who have offended and yet should get some sort of mental health care. There's no other provision other than prison. There's nowhere else to put them. This is something that has existed for quite some time and nobody has quite resolved the problem. I've visited many prisons in this country. Prison for what used to be called criminally insane is one of the most horrifying places that anybody could ever go to. I concur very much with what you said, I think, on Mrs. Smith. You put something so cleverly that I'm going to write it down. You say that so many decisions are made by politicians on important matters, and they do so to pander to a misinformed public. This, I think, is almost the most important thing that has come out of all of this. As so many people have said, nobody quite agrees with what is going on. Nobody quite knows what is happening anywhere. Nobody seems to follow any sort of proper route to find out what the position is. And I also say that prison exists not only to punish, but also to try and restore people back into normal life, one, and two, and this we must take into account, to protect the public who have suffered as a result of the behavior of some of these people. It's a two-way street. It doesn't exist all by itself. And I would also say that the courts in this country are remarkable. And anybody who says the courts did something absolutely ridiculous, they punished this person, they didn't punish the other person, and so on. And I would say to them every time, were you in court? Have you read all the papers? Have you seen the defendants? Have you been through the whole saga? Have you listened to what happened to the victims, if there were any? Do you know the whole story? And 99.9% of the time I would say, they don't. They don't know. It's all very open-ended. I was fascinated to hear what everybody's been saying. And you, Mrs. Smith, I think have hit the nail on the head.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Kimia. And I think when I was coming here, I was sitting with Bobby downstairs having a glass of wine. And he said there are three types of people in prison. Either they are bad, or sad, or mad. I think we can deal with bad people, and it is not necessary to keep them in prison all the time. We should deal with sad people as well, as you have heard today, everybody have said. And I think bad people should not be anyway in prison. They should be somewhere else. So let's start from the challenge you have given us today. Not me personally, but the Kuzuri Homes. We are in the process of consultation, I think. This is our second meeting. First one was in Kensington and Chelsea Town Hall, where your former deputy mayor and many others came. And David Nelson went from House of Commons to attend that meeting, who couldn't make it today, and I'm feeling that I'm going to speak to him later on that he's all right, because I think it is better. But I think I came here and I'm going out more educated, more informed. I hope everybody is. And I know that everybody, we are about 50 people, everybody wouldn't agree what we are trying to do or what the reforms is trying to do. There will be some vested interest and conflict of interest as well. But I can tell you, this is a program which will work with everybody and anybody if there is a possibility, and we will bring in more people and consult more people and try to learn as we go forward from this day and from yesterday, where we were yesterday. And you have to come along with us. Keep on telling us what you want in it, how you want it, and how should we do it, and where we are wrong. Thank you very much, all the speakers, everybody in this room. Thank you.